The big thing for me now that I've had cancer for a while, I realized that, you know, life's precious. And all of us see it every day in the service where somebody's in a fire, like auto accident, medical. People, you know, pass away every day.
This is what firefighters do. You respond to all sorts of emergencies. You help people in their darkest hour, at their time of greatest need. You fight tooth and nail to save lives, protect property, and stabilize incidents. But as you respond to alarms, you run across some pretty dangerous situations. When it comes to fires, you train obsessively to mitigate the obvious hazards. But it's sometimes easy to forget the big danger that lurks everywhere, at every fire, big or small. Carcinogens. These chemicals and particulates are everywhere at a fire incident, and firefighters are exposed to them at every stage of response, suppression, and overhaul. It is impossible to completely eliminate the threat, but there are actions you can take to minimize the risks to your families, your coworkers, and to yourselves. That's what this video is about, changing how firefighters operate on the fire ground so you can all live long, cancer-free lives.
As a new recruit, as a new guy that's been hired, you've got a 30-year career. Man, make it that 30 years, that'll be the best time you've had in your life. And I would also, on the flip side, and this is even more important for those guys my age that are gonna retire, I mean, you've put in 30 years. Do 30 more healthy.
So what are these best practices? Well, they're simple, cost-effective procedures all firefighters can do to minimize exposure to carcinogens and long-term cancer risk. Let's start with the easiest and most foolproof. Limit your exposure to the diesel exhaust that comes out of the fire apparatus. This means shutting down rigs when not in use and using exhaust ventilation systems whenever possible. Another simple step towards your healthy future is to wear full PPE and SCBA while fighting fire. Whether it's a structure fire, car fire, or dumpster fire, you need to stay protected from initial attack through overhaul. What about when you come out of a fire? When it comes to carcinogen exposure, this is one of the most potentially dangerous times. As time allows, the pump operator should set up a wet or dry decontamination station, depending on the weather. Proper decon starts with removing all of the debris and contaminants while still on air. If it's below freezing, remove those carcinogenic byproducts with a dry brush. Particulates will still be airborne, and you need to leave the decon area before doffing your gear. On warmer days, a thorough spray down from a designated decon hose line stretched from the attack engine is the best method. Decon each other. Don't expose the pump operator to the contaminants. Stay connected to your SCBA, breathing air until you've completed decon. Once you've given your all, it's time to rehydrate and enter rehab. Don't just walk straight into the rehab area. Take the time to wash your hands, face, and neck with soap and water. Retrofitting an engine with a warm water outlet utilizing the heat exchanger is a realistic method of providing effective hand washing at every emergency scene. If that's not available, disposable wet wipes will do the trick. Why would you risk ingesting, inhaling, or absorbing the very chemicals and particulates you've worked so hard to avoid?
Initially, I was like, I know, wear your air pack. I get it, you know, wear it through overhaul. I get it. But he actually talked about a whole different side of exposure, and it was the skin absorption piece, getting exposed to the skin, and how dirty gear and a dirty helmet and not showering after fires, how that's just prolonging the exposure. So after that class, I went, I washed my gear, cleaned my helmet, and changed my ways completely.
Once the fire is out, wait until the structure is cooled before beginning overhaul procedures. Always wear your full PPE and SCBA during overhaul. When you've been cleared from the scene, take the time to bag up your contaminated equipment and PPE. Make sure the bag is sealed and placed in a compartment that's separate from where the important cargo is, you and your fellow firefighters. Similarly, SCBAs should be kept separate until they can be thoroughly cleaned. Once you're back in quarters, your turnout gear can be washed in an extractor or sent off to a professional cleaning service. Masks should be carefully washed and decontaminated in a manner consistent with the manufacturer's instructions. Helmets should also be thoroughly cleaned to remove all carcinogens and contaminants. gloves must be washed and dried before being put back in service. These are just a few of the small, simple changes that can lead to a long and successful fire service career, uninterrupted by cancer or other illness. The job of firefighting is dangerous enough, so help each other out to use these best practices and minimize risk of carcinogen exposure so all firefighters can be healthy in, healthy out.